Good afternoon, everyone. I am here to present our recent work on proximity optimal predictive control algorithm for path tracking of self-driving cars. The key motivation behind this research was to come up with a control algorithm that can mitigate or bridge the gap between the simplistic error-driven controllers and optimal control strategies, and ensure effective path tracking of self-driving cars in real time. So coming to the research objectives, the first and foremost objective was to lay the foundation of the work by studying the established control algorithms which form the state of the art in the field. The next objective was to perform critical analysis of different corner cases and limitations of the state of the art. And based on the analyzed limitations or corner cases, come up with a better controller design for lateral as well as longitudinal dynamics of the vehicle. The final objective was to perform exhaustive experimentation in terms of dynamic simulation tests and present a comparative analysis of what we are proposing in this work against the state of the art. Coming to the literature review, the first and foremost control method that comes to mind in terms of trajectory tracking is obviously a simple PID controller. Now, although it has various advantages such as simplicity, the primary disadvantage of this method is that it functions well only around the operating point for which the controller was tuned, and therefore it is not a very robust technique. Gain scheduling methods can be used and they can be thought of as a way to mitigate this problem, but again, it is not a very good idea to do that, and it also adds to the complexity of the control design, as well as you cannot really schedule gains for each and every dynamic situation that the vehicle is expected to encounter. Coming to the next state of the art, which is the pure perceived control algorithm. This is a geometric path tracking algorithm, and it operates on the cross track error with respect to the reference trajectory and the vehicle pose. It uses a look ahead point on the reference trajectory, and the vehicle is technically in pursuit of that point. So if we consider this formulation of the pure perceived controller, we can clearly observe that the heading error of the vehicle is not at all considered here. Secondly, it assumes the availability of this look ahead point, which means that towards the end of the reference trajectory, if suppose this point what I'm showing here is the end of the reference trajectory, there is technically no look ahead point available or defined. So in that case, the controller can generate highly erratic commands, which is not at all desired. The third state of the art method is of Stanley controller, which was primarily designed to mitigate the drawbacks associated with the pure pursuit algorithm. Here we can see that the control algorithm is considering both heading as well as cross track errors. However, there is a lack of clear geometric formulation in this case. Particularly speaking, the inverse tangent function used for in the control law is, as what authors state, is just to minimize the overshoot in the control commands, and it does not form any geometric formulation with respect to the vehicle geometry and the reference trajectory. Secondly, it is a highly reactive or sluggish controller since it uses a closest point on the reference trajectory as opposed to a look ahead point. Now, if we consider that the initial cross-track error is high, then the vehicle is bound to move very suddenly towards the reference trajectory due to the highly erratic control commands generated by the controller. But this is not at all desired, so the authors propose a softening coefficient in the denominator. But again, if we are to tune this controller for smooth maneuvers, then the controller behaves in a highly sluggish manner under highly dynamic conditions. Finally, coming to the optimal control strategies, we are all aware of the model predictive controller. The key complexity in the design of this controller is that the control engineer has to come up with the cost function as well as the constraints that are to be fed to the optimizer to solve a constraint optimization problem. The weight assignment of each of the element associated with the cost function is another challenge, wherein the different elements can be competing and which might lead to corner cases and limitations. Finally, the prediction and control horizons are also to be perfectly tuned for getting the most out of this control law. Apart from these type of design complexities, the fundamental reason of limited use of this algorithm or the control strategy is the complexity involved in terms of computational burden. And if we see the structure of this controller, which has to numerically optimize the cost function given the weights and constraints and the plant model to come up with the control commands at each time step, predict the behavior of the model up to a certain prediction horizon, and then in a receding horizon manner apply control inputs to the vehicle. Then all of this for an onboard computer to compute in real time becomes very difficult. So in order to mitigate all these limiting factors and challenges associated with the state of the art, we have come up with a control law that can potentially minimize these. So for the simulation, we have used Carla simulator, which offers a realistic dynamic simulation. And we fixed the simulation time step to 50 milliseconds to avoid any effects of the changes due to the computation of the due to environment. So we selected the race track for the simulation, which consists of different maneuvers, like straight stretches as well as curved roads, and requiring different velocity profiles at different time instants. For vehicle representation, we are using a kinematic bicycle model as denoted here. However, it is not at all necessary or a strict requirement for the control algorithm that we are presenting. For the vehicle, we are assuming that the vehicle coordinate system is attached to the front axle of the vehicle as shown here. Coming to the trajectory representation, the trajectory is defined with respect to the global coordinate system, which is originally a spline tracing the center of the track, and which has been sliced into 1,274 waypoints with approximately 1 meter resolution between the between each waypoint. And then as the vehicle proceeds in the near neighborhood of the vehicle's current pose, we are again interpolating the waypoints with a higher resolution of 1 centimeter on line. Coming to the lateral and longitudinal control design, first I will speak about the lateral controller, which is the approximately optimal predictive control algorithm. So first we initialize a list of steering commands in the near neighborhood of the current previous one. And then we compute a look ahead distance based on the threshold value and the current speed of the vehicle to give it an adaptive nature. Based on the computed look ahead point and the current vehicle's position, we then compute a look ahead point index using this particular set of equation, which basically means that if there is a waypoint ahead available in the waypoint list that lies in the threshold value epsilon of the current vehicle pose, then we return that, else we just return the last waypoint to avoid instability. Then based on the index obtained through this equation, we just return the actual coordinates of the waypoint. Then we initialize the optimization parameters and enter the lightweight optimization loop. In the loop, for each of the element in the control command list, we first predict the vehicle location based on the current states and the particular element in the list using the state transition equation as shown here, wherein we are particularly interested in the x and y coordinates. And based on the predicted location, we compute the distance between this location of the vehicle and the look ahead point that we had earlier. And we return this control command that minimizes the distance between the predicted vehicle location and the actual look ahead point that is on the reference trajectory. This way we can theoretically guarantee that the trajectory tracking is going to be in an optimal way, where we try to minimize the distance between the predicted vehicle pose and the look ahead point. Coming to the longitudinal controller design, this is a coupled control law wherein the longitudinal controller is influenced by the lateral controller, and the steering command returned by the lateral controller is fed along with the limits for velocity as well as the steering. And a cutoff constant is introduced to first of all offset, to give an offset to avoid any dead zone that that is present in the vehicle due to changes in elevation, for example, and to limit the aggressiveness of the controller as well. Coming to the results, here I will be demonstrating of this dynamic simulation test for the different controllers. Firstly, coming to the PID controller, as you can see in the simulation, on the left hand side we have the vehicle state, and on the right hand side we can see the trajectory. The key thing to note in case of PID controller is that it is overshooting initially to above 50 degrees in terms of steering angle. And even in the further instances of the simulation, you can see that the there is a high fluctuation in the steering command, although the trajectory tracking looks fine. Now, since the throttle controller is adaptive in caused by the lateral control, you can see that the velocity is as well affected due to this performance. Coming to the pure pursuit control algorithm, if you recall, I stated that the drawback of this method is during the end phases, wherein the look ahead point suddenly vanishes. Now, to avoid that kind of instability, we actually kept feeding the last waypoint to the controller. However, obviously that is not the best solution. Another thing to note here is that when the control command is in the neighborhood of zero, the controller is providing a kind of fluctuating control command for the vehicle. However, since the there is a smooth transition in control commands, you can observe that the velocity is not affected very much here. Now, if you the Stanley control law, the initial part of the simulation itself shows that the controller has generated erratic commands due to its highly reactive nature. There is no other significant drawback of this controller, as I said. However, if we had to, avoid this kind of situation, we would have to tune it for a smoother response. Then it would have underperformed in the rest of the trajectory where there are sharp turns at a higher velocity. Again, as you can observe, the fluctuation is not very much, so the velocity is not affected that much. Now, coming to the proximally optimal predictive control algorithm that we are proposing in this work, you can clearly observe the smooth actuation as well as the range in which it is overshooting initially. Now, if you observe that all the controllers are overshooting initially, that is because the vehicle is spawned towards the left of the lane. And as I discussed earlier, the reference trajectory is through the center of the track. So that is why it overshoots initially. But if you see, there's a minimal overshoot in case of the proximally optimal predictive control algorithm that we are proposing. And as a result, the velocity profile also, if you observe, it's pretty smooth. Coming to the tracking metrics, all the results here are indicated in the mean absolute error terms. So for cross-track error and heading error, if you observe, for PID controller, the cross-track error was maximum, and for pure pursuit algorithm, the heading error was maximum. This is likely to happen since the controller does not, care about the heading error at all. Coming to the controller that we are proposing in this work, you can clearly observe that there is a minimum of cross-track as well as heading errors for the control strategy. Coming to the latency, we have implemented the entire control algorithm in Python. And which is an interpreted language. So obviously the values that you can see here are already high. Since we had the simulation engine as well as the trajectory preprocessing pipeline and the lateral and longitudinal controllers running in a single machine, the latency came out to be around 3.2 milliseconds, which roughly translates to a control loop of over 300 hertz. And this is a very much real time execution. Conclusion, I would like to say that we have formulated and presented an efficient path tracking algorithm which has an adaptive look ahead and a predictive nature similar to model predictive controllers, and it performs proximal optimization of the control commands, which ensures the actuation smoothing. Finally, it has a 2D coupled control law or mechanism wherein the longitudinal controllers can be of any variation. For example, here we are proposing adaptive throttle controller, which was introduced in one of our earlier works, but simple PID controllers or any type of control algorithms as well can be used. Coming to the experimental validation of this approach, we performed a series of dynamical simulation tests, and the comparative analysis has revealed, evidently, as you can observe, that the path tracking of the vehicle was highly efficient and in real time, with minimum cross-track and heading errors in the case of the control algorithm that we have proposed. So thank you. If you have any questions, I would be happy to answer them.
Okay, Chinmay, thanks to you. It's a very well made presentation. So thanks once again. Let's move to the next paper.
Thank you, everybody.